some of the things that we have learned this school year. In construction, there are lots and lots of things that pertain to construction, but for the sake of time, I will only share a few. Right here, in the beginning of the school year, we made an instruction manual on how to build benches. Lately, we have built doghouses, and we had to come up with a good design, and we were able to build them. We have to calculate all the costs, all the material costs before we buy any of the wood that we use to build projects. And also, we, as Jaquan said, we do help Texas Rent Project, so we've had to learn the Americans with Disability Act guidelines for wheelchair ramps. We also learn about health and nutrition. We have to learn about insulin, the fat storing molecule, and hydrogenated oils like margarine, and ghrelin, the hunger molecule. We have to cook our own meals every day, so we do have to eat healthy. We learn about genetically modified foods and GM corn. We have to learn how to read the nutritional labels on the back of food so we can know what we're eating and putting in our bodies. And we learned about monosodium glutamate, which creates more ghrelin, causing you to eat more. We manage the inventory in our kitchen. So when we run out of things, we have to go, buy things. So we have to purchase, we have to go in the store and purchase it, and we have to budget, because we have a set amount of money that we have to spend on food every month. We have to learn how to write checks. When I'm in the store, I have to write the check in order to purchase the food. Our inventory lists are in Microsoft Excel, so we have to know how to do that. And we do comparison shopping and talking to the store personnel by phone or in person. We also do a class about Dave Ramsey's Foundations of Personal Finance. And here are the five foundations concerning a teenager. You have to have $500. You have to have $500 in an emergency fund. You have to get out of debt if you are in debt. Pay cash for your car, pay cash for college, and build wealth and give. Out of these lessons, we have constructed a short survey, which you should have already done. We put them on Wonder Polls just to see how the community will respond. Question one would be, is credit score or FICO necessary? The answer to this question is no. Because, as I said in the first foundation, you're trying to stay out of debt. So, if you're trying to stay out of debt, you really wouldn't need this anyway. Are car payments a way of life? When you make a car payment, the car is not really yours until you pay it off. So technically, you're in debt. So you're trying to stay out of debt. But if you were disciplined, you would save up that money and you would pay cash for the car. So the answer would be no. Is money the main cause for divorces? The answer is yes. Dave Ramsey cited statistics showing that money is the main cause for divorces. Do you save your leftover money at the end of the month? The answer should be yes, because when you save your money at the end of the month, that's how you build wealth. Do you think 70% of Americans live paycheck to paycheck? The answer to this question is yes, they do. Do you have at least $1,000 in your savings for emergencies? The answer should, pertains to you. But you should have at least $1,000, because emergencies do come up, and you shouldn't have to rely on credit to fix those emergencies for you. So you should always have $1,000 laying around or in a bank account. Is there ever a time that it's okay to co-sign for everything, mainly loans? The answer to this question is no. First of all, you shouldn't be trying to go into debt and trying to get a loan anyway. Second of all, that person might not be as faithful, and you might end up having to pay for it all. Do you think debt is normal? We had a lot of people answer this question. The answer to this question is no, it shouldn't. Because first of all, you're trying to stay out of debt. And debt is just, it means you're a slave to the other person, so it's not normal. Do you think a 30-year mortgage is a great deal? The answer to this question is no, because in the end, you actually end up paying almost more than, almost 200% of the house, or what the house actually costs. Is buying a new rather than a used car a good decision? Well, you're trying to stay out of debt, so you wouldn't buy the car exactly new, because once you drive it out the lot, it loses exactly 1/4 of its of the price that you would pay for it. So you should save up and you should buy a car with cash. And back to some of the things we've done a lot of public speaking, like I'm doing now. We spoke at Antioch Church, that's Mission Edge's home church back in Palestine. We spoke here at Colonial Hills. We spoke at Southern Oaks. We spoke at Caldwell Elementary. And we spoke at Jackson Elementary to Spanish-speaking parents.